Stand-up paddleboarding is one of the fastest-growing water sports around. The reasons for this are simple. It's fun, it's great exercise, and pretty much anyone can do it. Beginner-level stand-up paddleboards generally fall into two categories. All-around boards, designed for exploring flatwater lakes, rivers, and oceans, and race and touring boards, built for speed and long-distance paddles. Most boards weigh between 25 and 40 pounds and measure 10 to 14 feet in length, giving plenty of options for new paddlers looking to find the perfect board. All stand-up paddle boards have three common features. A handle, typically cut in the center of the board for easy access and balance carrying. A cushioned deck pad for increased comfort and traction. And fins, which allow the board to track straight when paddling. Apart from these common features, boards come in many different shapes and sizes, all of which affect how they perform. Stand-up paddleboards are basically bigger versions of traditional surfboards. The larger size yields more buoyancy, which is critical for keeping a person afloat, even when they are not moving. The overall buoyancy of a board is affected by its length, width, and thickness. Often, this information is listed as board volume and is measured in liters. The material a board is constructed from can also affect the buoyancy. It is important to find a board with enough buoyancy to float your body weight sufficiently, because the lower a board sits in the water, the less stable it becomes. For example, on any given board, lighter paddlers will float higher and therefore be more stable than a heavier person on the same board. This is due to the fact that the heavier person will cause the board to be lower in the water. The length and width of a stand-up paddleboard also impact how the board moves through the water. A longer board will move faster, straighter, and more efficiently through the water. So beginner paddlers will want to get the longest board they can store and transport by themselves, generally between 10 feet 6 inches and 14 feet long. Width is a major factor in a board's overall side-to-side stability. Typically, the wider a board, the more stable it is. Narrower boards can be a lot faster, but they can also be more difficult to stand on because they have less side-to-side stability. For beginners, a wider board of 30 inches or more is a great place to start. The final feature of a stand-up paddleboard to be aware of is its hull shape. There are two main types, a planing hull and a displacement hull. A traditional surfboard-style planing hull is round and flat and literally planes across the surface of the water by pushing water down while lifting the nose of the board. It's a good all-around choice for beginner-level paddlers because it is typically very stable. A displacement hull has a pointed nose, similar to a kayak or canoe, that is designed to cut through the water. Displacement hulls are a great choice for those interested in paddling longer distances. They can still be very stable and are generally more efficient than a planing hull. Stand-up paddleboarding is a fun and easy way to get outside. Finding the right board for yourself may take some experimenting, so the best way to get started is to get on as many different boards as you can. Ask about a demo at your nearest stand-up paddleboard-equipped REI.